गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर टॉपिक, डायगोनल्स ऑफ ए पॉलीगन एंड बेसिस ऑफ साइड्स। वी कैन डिफरेंशिएट द पॉलीगन्स वी कैन डिस्कस टुडे। बिफोर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक, स्टूडेंट जस्ट रिकॉल दैट व्हाट वी हैव लर्न इन प्रीवियस क्लास। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी कैन लर्न concave polygons and convex polygons. Today we can discuss the diagonals of a polygons. So when we say the diagonal, the word diagonal, when a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices of a polygon, a line segment, we know the line segment is a part of a line. So what is the difference between line and line segment? The line, it not have starting point and ending point. We can extend both side by indefinite distance. So for the line segment, a part of a line we called as a line segment. That means it have a starting point and it have a particular ending point. So these line segment connecting to non-consecutive vertices. When we say non-consecutive vertices, for example, here in this figure, these are the side. This one side, this is second side, this is third side, this is fourth side, and this is fifth side. So when we say consecutive vertices, suppose this side and this side connects this vertices. ಈ ಸೈಡು ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಸೈಡು ಎಲ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗಿವೆ, ಈ ವರ್ಟಿಸಿಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗಿವೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ ವರ್ಟಿಸಿಸ್, ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ ವರ್ಟಿಸಿಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಟಿಸಿಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, we called a non-consecutive vertices, we called non-consecutive vertices. So in singular term we called as vertex, and in the plural form we can say as vertices. So for example, look at here. So this side connect to this vertices connect to this vertices, and this one vertices connect to this and this and this. These are all non-consecutive vertices. So these non-consecutive vertices we called as a diagonal of a polygon. Diagonal of a polygon. Suppose this is a pentagon polygon, because the sides 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 sides. So if it is a 5 sides, we can called as a pentagon. So these are all lines which we called as diagonals. Now we can easily know that the diagonal means when two non-consecutive vertices joins, it forms a diagonal. So we can move another one concept, that is, okay, look at all these figures. These are the some example. We take a square, how much diagonals happens? 1 and 2. Take this parallelogram, this is also happen 1 and 2 diagonals. Suppose this is a concave polygon. The concave polygon, its diagonals is that means non-consecutive vertices are joined like this and like. So these are the diagonals of this figure. So in this figure, these are the diagonal of this, what we call convex polygon. So these are the some examples of non-consecutive joining of vertices. So let's we move on to another topic, that is the types of polygons. So how can we differentiate the polygons by its sides? So the more sides, the more sides forms most diagonal, because the more sides forms more vertices. So more vertices forms more diagonals. So next we can discuss the types of diagonal basis of sides. If it is a three sides, we called as the polygon name is triangle. Students, let's think that in a triangle, can be possible to draw a diagonal? So suppose this is a triangle, can we join consecutive lines? No, it's not a possible, because if you want to join a non-consecutive lines, means at least it have four sides. So in a triangle only have three sides. These are all consecutive vertices. No possible to draw a non-consecutive vertices. So if it is a sides have three, we called as triangle. The sides are four, we called as a square or rectangle. And sides are five, means, see, these are the five sides, we called as a pentagon. Six sides means we called as a hexagon. Seven means it is a heptagon. Eight means it is a octagon. 9 means nonagon. 10 means decagon. It we called as decagon. So these are the some types of polygons. Students, I hope you already understand all these things. This is a simple topic. Next class we can discuss some of the another extra types of polygons and angles formed by polygons. So let's stop here. Thank you.